Hi guys, so today we will study this image generation using the stable overlay transform. And, we have a MATLAB code here, and please visit my website. This is www.iitmatlabprojectassignments.com for more stuff. These three instructions are just to clear the memory. I'll write it down. Just to clear the memory. And this is my image. I'm taking this image. And this is my test image. So I will run my program here. I'm gonna put noise in this image, and by using discrete overlay transform, I'm gonna denoise it. Okay, basically it's a very simple procedure. Now, in this step, in line number 13, I'm putting some Gaussian noise in the image, and I can show it to you like that. But before executing this command, let me just check. This is uint8 only, so I have nothing to worry about. Okay, so this is my noise difference. I have put some noise, some Gaussian noise. The default value of mean is 0 and the variance is 0.01. So it's a very little noise I'm putting here in this scalar image. Okay, so this is that type of the threshold. This is basically the type of the threshold. You can use soft threshold or hard threshold. It doesn't depend upon the results from which thresholding techniques you are getting better results. Okay, it depends upon the image as well. So here I'm applying a DWT. Basically, I'm using three level DWT. Okay. It's a two dimension office. It's an office thing because my image is 2D. Okay. So in this line, I have applied DWT 2 on the J image. Of course, the noisy image. I'm using simply hard wavelet, and or you can say DB1, I guess. Okay. So these are my approximate coefficients, and these three are my detail coefficient. Okay, in case of 2D, I am getting 3. That's the horizontal, vertical, and diagonal. Okay, but if I apply the DWT on 1D signal, then I will be getting only one detail coefficient. That is simply CD1. Okay, you can check it in MathWorks Help Center or Support Center or somewhere, I guess. Okay, so I am applying again DWT. This is the first level. Okay, it's fairly simple actually. This is the first level, this is the second level. Okay, this is the third level. In some paper you will find that people have used 4 level DWT, but you can use 4 or 5 or maximum 6, but we don't go beyond 6 generally. Okay, I'm using here third. This is the general program. You can use it as per the paper. It's a very flexible program. You can use it anywhere. Okay, I will find and apply the threshold. Basically, what I need to do to the denoising, I need to apply the thresholding technique. But on what thing I am applying thresholding technique? Basically, I put the noise in my image, this image, okay, in the cameraman image, this here, and I get here J image. Okay, so I will put some threshold in this image, basically in the wavelet coefficients I have find here in the third level, second level and first level, in all the levels I'll put some threshold to eliminate the noisy coefficients only. Okay, and I have two type of threshold, either hard threshold or soft threshold. You can find the difference on that anywhere, but hard thresholding is simply eliminate the whole coefficient, whereas soft thresholding keeps some of the component and delete the rest. Okay, so I'm using this technique to find the threshold. So what is my sig thrash? I can find it out here on the net. What is my sig thrash? Actually, I forgot I wrote it. A while back, but it's not a problem here. Okay, it's going. It's a little connection, it's slow. So here we are. Sig thrash. Okay. So sig thrash basically it's a function which is used to find sigma and threshold for a matrix. Okay, and first I'm dealing with the third level, so I'm finding the threshold. Okay, I'm finding the threshold for this CH3 matrix. Okay, like this. This is my CH3 matrix. I'm finding the threshold for CH3 matrix. This is CH3. Okay, and the level is third, so I will find the threshold for CS3, same here CV3, same here for CD3. Okay, and now the W thrash function is, this is used to apply the threshold. Okay, so what can I say? My y_CH3 is the denoised matrix for the image, basically deconstructed image. Okay, so same here with the CV3, CD3. Okay, so CV3, CD3. Okay, DCS2, same I'm doing with the second level, same I'm doing the first level. So now in this step I'm applying the inverse DWT, and this y_j is my denoised image. And you can find the PSNR also. Always you can compare the y_j or j with I. Okay, so I'm gonna save it and I'm gonna run it. This is my I. I will show you all the images one by one. Okay, so I'm gonna run it. Program. Okay, so this I can run it like that. Program. Okay. Okay, it's already ran, so I'm sure. Oh, I don't have to write it, I can just do that. Yes, so this I am show I. Okay, this was my original image. Okay, and this is my noisy image. make some noise. And there is my here. This is my denoised image. Okay, so you can see the difference. Okay, you can see the difference. And you can always calculate the peak signal noise ratio, basically PSNR. You can always calculate it. That's not an issue here. Okay, and you can calculate it by using this formula. So that's it for today, guys. And today we learned denoised image is indescribable transform. And I'm here just using only one algorithm. You can use, there are multiple algorithms to denoise images in indescribable transform. You can find the threshold through multiple methods. Okay, I'm finding the threshold by using the function. You can find the threshold by using the there are various functions. You can, I'll give you the ref, but I don't have references now, but I do have one. You can find the threshold by using this function, square root of sigma multiplied by log of some variable. I guess you can use this formula as well. There are multiple algorithms to denoise the image using discriminative transform. You just need to change the way to find the threshold. Okay, so this is how we denoise the image using discrete Doppler transform. And that's it, guys, for today.